Meh, meh. Hello, Grandpa.
Meh, meh.
Hello, my sweetie sheep.
Merry Christmas, sheepy.
Merry Christmas, Grandpa.
So, why are you sad, sheepy? It's Christmas time, you should be happy.
I'm so sad because we didn't decorate our farm like the other animals. All my friends decorated their farms and mangers for Christmas.
So, why didn't you do that with our family here on the farm? With your grandma, Mrs. Sheba, for example?
She's busy brushing her fur.
Bah, bah, I have a softy fur. Bah, bah, just like a smiley bear. Bah, 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 softy fur. Bah, 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 smiley bear.
Ah, women. How about Uncle Donkey?
He's busy too.
Why?
He's trying to test how smart he is by quizzing.
Oh, really? I don't think he's that smart.
If you go to visit your friend, how many people will be at your friend's house? If you know that he lives alone. One. Just my friend. No. Oh, two. Because I'm going to take a present with me. Yoo-hoo!
How about Uncle Camel?
He needs rest.
Rest? After what? He hasn't traveled since...
since he was born.
How about Auntie Cow?
She is out today.
So, where is she?
She's buying milk for us.
What? Aunt Cow is buying milk? What a miserable family.
I'm so sad, Grandpa.
Oh, honey, you know, I want to tell you something. Christmas is not about decorations, treats, or presents. It's all about Jesus Christ, who was born in a manger in our grandfather's farm long years ago.
Huh, Grandpa? Can you tell me the story, please?
I was just reading this book. It's about the history of our great family. And it's called The Blessed Animals. They are very famous. You should be proud of your grandfather's sheepy. Jesus Christ chose to be born among them in a manger because he was so humble, more than all humans.
Wow, tell me the whole story, please, please.
Once upon a time, there was a priest named Zechariah and his wife called Elizabeth. They were righteous before God, walking in all his commandments. But they had no children, and they were old. And one day, Zechariah was serving before God in the temple. And then Gabriel, the angel of the Lord, appeared to him saying,
"Do not be afraid, Zechariah, for your prayer is heard, and your wife, Elizabeth, will bear you a son, and you shall call his name John. And you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth, for he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and shall drink neither wine nor strong drink. He will also be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb, and he will turn many of the children of Israel to the Lord their God."
"How do I know this? I'm an old man, and my wife is old too."
"I am Gabriel, who stands in the presence of God, and was sent to speak to you and bring you these glad tidings. But behold, you will be mute and not able to speak until the day these things take place, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled in their own time."
Huh? What happened next, Grandpa? Did he become mute?
Yes, Sheepy. When he came out from the temple, he couldn't speak, and people around him knew that he'd seen a vision from God.
Wow, what about his wife?
Oh, that part from the story comes later. Let's talk about the angel Gabriel. He was sent by God to another city called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary. Then Gabriel the angel said to her,
Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women.
What kind of greeting is this? And why?
Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and will be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.
How can this be, since I am not married?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore, also, that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God. Now indeed Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is now the sixth month for her, who was called barren, for with God nothing will be impossible.
Behold, I am the maidservant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word.
Do you think I can bring forth little sheep like Elizabeth?
Sure, Grandma. There is nothing impossible with the God. Right, Grandpa?
Huh? Yeah, sure.
Please continue telling us this nice story.
Mary went quickly to Elizabeth to serve her. Zechariah and Elizabeth's house wasn't near to Joseph and Mary's house, but she decided to go into the hills, to the city of Judah, to serve her relative.
What a helpful person! Who is he?
She is St. Mary.
Oh, what a helpful girl! Who is St. Mary?
She is the mother of God.
Oh, wow! Who is God?
Oh, it's not a quiz, Uncle Donkey. I'm going to tell you later. Now listen to the rest of the story.
Which story?
Oh, man!
Which man you're talking about?
Mary went to Elizabeth to help her in her pregnancy. And once Elizabeth met Mary, a strange thing happened to her.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. But why is this granted to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For indeed, as soon as the voice of your greetings sounded in my ears, the baby leaped in my womb for joy. Blessed is she who believed, for there will be a fulfillment of the things which were told her from the Lord.
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit has rejoiced in God my Savior. For behold, henceforth, all generations will call me blessed.
And when Elizabeth gave birth to her son, she called him John. Her neighbors told her, "No one among your relatives had this name." And they asked Zechariah. So he asked for a writing tablet and wrote, "John." Immediately he started to talk, and all people marveled.
And what happened to St. Mary after that?
She came back to her house, and after that, Caesar Augustus ordered that all the world should be registered.
What is the meaning of registration, Grandpa?
I was about to ask the same question!
I'm sure you were.
I know. It means that all the people should go to their native towns and sign up there, so they can count all the people that belongs to each town, and the king will know the number of the people in the whole world.
Exactly, Mrs. Sheba. And Joseph took Mary and went to his native town, which is called Bethlehem. And while they were there, the days were completed for Mary to be delivered.
Joseph asked everywhere in the village for a place for them, but there was no room for them in the homes. So, St. Mary brought forth her son Jesus in a farm like this one which we live in. She wrapped him in swaddling cloth and laid him in a manger.
Like this one which we eat from?
Yes, sheepy.
Among animals like us?
Yeah, Mrs. Sheepa.
Like here? Like us?
Yeah, Uncle Donkey.
Because of that, the book which you were reading called the Blessed Animals?
Not only the animals. I mean, our grandfathers were blessed, Sheepy. The whole earth is blessed because Jesus, the Son of God, came to our world. He loves all people, and he came to the world for the salvation of all people.
And no one came to see him?
I'm going to tell you, Mrs. Sheepa. At that time, there was in the same country some shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their sheep by night. And suddenly, the angel of the Lord appeared to them and said,
"Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloth, lying in a manger.
Glory be to God in the highest, and peace on earth, goodwill towards men."
"Let's go to Bethlehem and see what the Lord told us."
The shepherds looked for Jesus in the town, and when they found him in the manger, as the angel told them, they told everyone what the angel told them, and all those who heard it marveled. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for the things that they have heard and seen. They were joyful because they saw Jesus, the Son of God.
I was dreaming a wonderful dream.
Finally, you woke up, Uncle Camel. I hope you had a nice rest.
It was great, Sheepy. Especially the dream.
And what was your dream, my dear?
I dreamed that Grandpa was telling us a story about Christmas.
Oh, really?
What a wonderful dream.
It wasn't a dream, Uncle Camel. Actually, I was telling them this story, and probably you heard us while you were resting.
So it wasn't a dream? I was hearing you. Wow! It was a nice story, Grandpa. I can tell you something else. I've heard from my grandpa about Jesus too.
Really? Please do, Uncle Camel.
Go ahead, Uncle Camel! Go ahead, Uncle Camel, please!
Go ahead, Uncle Camel, please!
There were three camels for three wise men from the east. These wise men saw a big bright star in the sky, and they knew that this star represented the birth of a new king. So they traveled for days to Jerusalem.
Where is he who was born King of the Jews? We have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him.
When Herod the king heard that, he was troubled. He was caring about himself. He thought that Jesus wants to be the king instead of him. So he was thinking about killing baby Jesus. Can you imagine?
Calm down, Uncle Camel. That can be happen.
Yeah, sure.
What an evil guy.
What happened next, Uncle Camel?
The star which the wise men had seen in their country
appeared to them again and went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. The wise men opened the treasures which my grandfathers were carrying and presented gifts to Jesus.
The camels which carried the gifts to Jesus were your grandfather's, Uncle Camel?
Yes, son.
And what are these gifts?
They were gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Myrrh? Why?
The gifts refer to Jesus himself, sheepy. Gold, for he is the King of Kings. Frankincense, for he is the greatest priest. And myrrh, for his suffering, because he would die for the salvation of all people.
What a story!
So this is Christmas, sheepy. We are celebrating the birth of Jesus our King. We ask him to be born in our hearts and give us his heavenly joy and peace.
As the angels praise, glory to God in heaven and peace on earth and goodwill towards men.
Moo moo moo! And finally I came!
Punt cow, you missed a lot. Grandpa is telling us the story of Christmas.
Oh, really?
Did you buy milk, Don Cow?
Of course not!
Why?
Guess what?
What?
I bought Christmas decorations!
Yay! Thank you, Don Cow.
Oh, what a nice tree.
Let's do it!
And now? Let's sing a nice song together for Christmas.
In Bethlehem on a winter night, where shepherds with their sheep so white, when suddenly came down the rays of an angel singing praise.
Guess who's born? It's Jesus Christ. Lose your troubles, give a high five. Have no fear and go and see the Son of God, the little baby.
Now three wise men saw a star glowing brightly from afar. On their camels traveling, they carried gifts fit for a king.
Singing, guess who's born? It's Jesus Christ. He is God's beloved child. He'll bring peace to one and all. Let's go meet the baby small.
They found him in a stable cold, just like the angel had foretold,
with his loving mind, Pa, underneath the shining star. Singing, Jesus Christ, the Prince is here. Joy and happiness is near. Sing and dance and have some fun. Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas.
كده حلو مص مص محدش يضحك سنانه هتطلع
صوت على الجهاز يا
بنضف من العرض الشياطين اللي كانوا هنا فين؟
الشياطين اطفوا بسرعه الف النور
الف النور الف النور تجربه الف النور تيست 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 تيست
لا لا بعيد السرعة عشان السلام تقطع. لا لا اضحكي اضحكي بجد. لا اضحكوا بجد مش هزار. لا اضحكوا بجد. برقوا بقى برقوا عشان عليكم كمان. لا حول ولا قوة الا بالله. حاجة اعملها يا جدعان معانا دي. ايوه واحدة تبتدي انزل اللي بعده مين عايز يقول حاجة؟
With his loving mind, pop underneath the shining star. Singing, Jesus Christ, the Prince is here.
انا عايز صراحه عزيمه على الراديو بصي انا هقفل كل حاجه هقفل كل مسامير انا عايز اللي يبص هنعمل اخر مره
بس انا اوصل يعني لو يعني لو حاجه طلعت من جنب نورت نوصها يعني كروب طب اقعدي يا حنان وارفعي لعروستنا
عشان ده الفاينل عشان هنبتدي
يلا يا حنان اقعدي وارفعي لعروستنا اقعدي يا لولا وارفعي العروسه متاكد ان كله طالع
ماشي
انا قفلت كله بحيث ان انا هسيب ساد
انا مبسوط انا مبسوط
مش
حاجه ولا حاجه تحت
حاجه
تحت حاولوا بس يا جماعه تقربوا على بعض يعني انت الكامل ده لازم يجي برضه
اه يعني بصوا اللي هيطلع ما يطلعش من الطروف قوي
سنطروا نفسكم بصوا خليكم اه يعني مش عايزين
عميل انت اكبر مني الاول بتعمل
اتنين كمان
انا واقفه اهو
ويت 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 الست عرايس كل العرايس يعني هاتوا
ويت 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 لو صبر القاتل ما كانش اتقتل
ادوني ثانيه واحده معلش رجعي ثاني
عارفاها
اطلع بالعرايس اطلع بالعرايس انزل بالعرايس
يا مينا
ما هيش بس عشان اشوف بس الاول بس ايوه كده تمام كده كده تمام الصراحه الصراحه خلاص طب نروح ونيجي بكره عشان نكمل
هنستنى
اديك الشغل لولو ومعانا لولو ومعانا ميري ورا ميري من مدرجات الدرجه الثالثه بتشجعنا من مدرجات الدرجه الثالثه وانجي ومعانا حنان حنونا يلا الفيرويل بتاعنا والجول كيبر دميان اهي الجول كيبر دميان ومعانا يا جماعه من الافراد نور 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 معانا مير ومعانا كوكي 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 نور اتفي نور اتفي فين يا كوكي تعالى اصور معاهم يا عم عايز اصور معاهم
كده سيلفي
طالع عندك
انت عبير لا انت كلام
الفضايح.
ما تلبسش بقى النص هنا على الموبايل. هات النص هنا على الشغل.
دي الفضايح.
الفضايح.
وده الاسبرين بتاع الامتحانات. ده البرشام. ده البرشام بس عريضة قوي.
صور السكريبت اللي وانجي عامله العرض بالعكس. تعالي يا انجي. طيب من عندك يا انجي. مين يا جماعه؟ جميله
جميله جميله جميله جدا
يا جماعه. موجود لازم يتصور. شغال على
البروجيكتور.
على البروجيكتور.
باي باي.
انا كوكي كوكي. تعالي
and times and hearts on time. Merry Christmas, everyone.